Hi everyone, welcome back. You want to know how to install and set up Google Chrome? Stay tuned and I'm going to show you how. This is White Armor Consulting and today I'm going to show you how to install and set up Google Chrome for maximum security and privacy. Let's begin. First, we're going to open up Firefox or Internet Explorer. From there, you're going to type in google.ca, type out download Chrome. You're going to look for www.google.com/chrome and click that link and click download Chrome. Here you're going to have an option to help make Google Chrome better by automatically sending usage statistics and crash reports to Google. This is your choice. I like to keep it on to help them out. Accept and install. After it installs, you can close the browser and then you're going to go to the download location and you're going to double click Chrome setup.exe. Now it's going to download and it's going to start installing on your PC or phone, whichever you're downloading it to. From here, what you're going to do is you're going to hit continue. And you now have just installed Google Chrome. Next, we're going to go to the settings. And here's where we're going to configure the browser from the default settings to a more custom state. That way you know how your browser is going to respond with all the different things that you're doing. So first, we're going to go to search engines. Here, you're going to click the arrow and you're going to start removing the search engines that you don't use with this browser. I like to keep Google as my default, but you can add whichever you like. After you've done that, you're going to hit the back arrow and you're going to go down to default browser. You're going to make it your default browser. From there, you're going to go to on startup and you're going to pick one of the three options that are below. I like to keep it on open a new tab. So when your browser opens, it'll just be a brand new tab that loads nothing. And then you can just type in the addresses that you want to go to. Next, we're going to click advanced. Here's where we're going to configure all the different privacy and security settings. Now these settings are the most important when you first download Google Chrome, because this is going to help stop data from being leaked to Chrome or to Google, to help with predictive services and web services that try to learn your behaviors. So for the first three options, I like to turn those off because we don't want to use a prediction service to load pages more quickly. We don't want to use a prediction service to help complete searches and URLs typed in the address bar. And we don't want to use a web service to help resolve navigation errors, because this means that they're going to be reading our data. Now, the next three options are personal preference. I like to turn them on. So automatically send some system information and page content to Google to help detect dangerous apps and sites, protect you and your device from dangerous sites, and automatically send usage statistics and crash reports to Google. Next, send a do not track request with your browsing traffic. I like to turn that off because websites mostly don't listen to that do not track option. And then the last option there is use a web service to help resolve spelling errors. We don't want to use any services for that. After you're done there, you're going to click content settings, and then you're going to click cookies. Here, you're going to allow sites to save and read cookie data. What you want to do is you want to leave that on. Keep local data only until you quit your browser. You're going to turn that on and block third-party cookies from saving and reading cookie data. You're going to turn that on and then hit back. Then you're going to go to location. Here, you're going to make sure it says ask before accessing, back, and then you're going to go through camera, make sure it says the same thing, microphone, same thing, notifications, ask before sending. Leave JavaScript as allowed, and for Flash, you want to make sure it is always set to ask first. After that, we're going to move down to pop-ups, make sure that it's set to blocked. And then ads, blocked on sites that tend to show intrusive ads. Make sure that that is set to blocked. By clicking it on, you allow it. By turning it off, it stays blocked. From here, you're going to go to background sync, allow recently closed sites to finish sending and receiving data. We're going to turn that off, so we don't want that to happen. When we close our browser, we close it and we want everything to stop. From here, you're going to go to automatic downloads and you're going to make sure that ask when a site tries to download files automatically after the first file, you're going to make sure that that's checked on. Make sure that that's checked off. We do not allow automatic downloading of any kind. Then you're going to scroll down. And that's pretty much it for this section. And you're going to hit back. You're going to go to the next setting, which is passwords and forms. Autofill settings. We're going to make sure that those are off. And make sure any addresses and credit cards are removed. Then you're going to go to manage passwords. You're going to make sure that those are off as well, because we don't want our browser managing any passwords of ours. And you're done with that section. Then you're going to move down to downloads. Ask where to save each file before downloading. You're going to make sure that that's on. Then you're going to scroll down. You're going to look under system. Here, we're going to go continue running background apps when Google Chrome is closed. We're going to turn that off. Open proxy settings. You're going to make sure you click that. Go to LAN settings. Make sure all options are off and click OK. Now, if you are using a proxy service or VPN service, this is where you would configure it. After you're done here, we're going to go to clean up computer. And you're going to make sure that this is turned on. Now, if you click find, it's going to start scanning your PC for malicious apps. And it's going to send that data to Google. And this helps protect your PC. Now, this is your choice. You can turn it off if you don't want the browser to be doing that. I prefer to keep it on just so I have it a little extra help. After you've done that, your browser is pretty much configured. When you're surfing the web and you're using Chrome, every now and then you want to make sure you come to the clear browsing data and you want to make sure these options are checked on and you want to hit clear data. Make sure the time range is all time and clear it. Advanced shows more options, so make sure that there's no passwords, no autofill, no content settings. Everything can be turned on. You can make sure it says all time, clear data. That way it keeps your browser very clean. It doesn't store any of your personal information and you're pretty much good to surf the web. That's pretty much it. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like and subscribe to show your support. If you use Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram, I've linked my profiles below in the description. And if you have any questions at all, please let me know below. As always, thank you so much for watching and take care.